This note is not just an A. It's in this A, there's an aura of music which we know. So we can relate it to some Mozart or maybe some Bach or Beethoven. So this is an instrument with a lot of connotation. And this was the starting point of my project, my private project at Lexikon, which I did secretly in the evening at night when I was alone in my studio, testing different algorithms that I invented that are supposed to simulate playing modes that were used in the history on the piano. There are some playing modes that you all might know. Can you give me an example? Typical piano gestures, piano cliches.
Eglissando.
Very good, eglissando. Something else comes into your mind?
Trill.
A trill? Oh, yeah. Yeah. Very good. What else? There's this, what they call Alberto bass, Alberto bass, sort of accompanying things, arpeggios, melodies, chords. Yeah? So I was taking it apart and trying to build little programs that were able to create an infinite number of these different little things. And as you mentioned the trill, I was actually starting with the trill, because I think the most simple musical object in the piano music is the trill. Can someone explain me or tell me or tell us how could you describe a trill? Who is a pianist here? Nope, no pianist. But the trill also exists on the violin and the cello, right? It's an ornamentation, this is the feel from the barrel, but structurally, what does the trill consist of?
The pitch to the note above.
Two pitches, so, yeah. And what's the relation between the pitches?
Like a falsetto?
Yeah, right. Or?
Or
yes. So these are only possibilities. The figure of a trill is two notes. There's a main note and a secondary note, and the distance between them is a half or whole tone step. And okay, these are the pitches. What's about the rhythm or the inner structure, the tempo structure of the trill?
And even time doesn't have alternation.
Alternation, yes, even time. And what's about the tempo?
Fast.
It's fast. Can the tempo be modified?
Sure.
Yes, it must be. I mean, at least if you're a good player, you don't play it very regularly, but you make some. Yes, accelerando, maybe also in the terms of the dynamics, and some speeding up, speeding down at the end. So, the speed. The model consists of the definition of this, the notes. So we have these two notes. What was the interval?
Half tone step,
okay. And it was in a middle register on the piano, and it had a very even speed. So it were 10 beats per second. Every 100 milliseconds there was a da-da-da-da-da. Yeah? Okay, the one thing is that you can start now changing, let's say, the speed. Instead of having this even, we can say we speed it up. We start with 100 milliseconds, and in the end, we become very fast, let's say, something by 60 or so milliseconds. So it's nearly a doubling in speed. And now we need a duration. The duration, let's say, 4 seconds. Yeah? So the same trill, but it's now speeded up. We can also change the register. Now it was in the middle. Now we can make it quite low. Let's separate the different parameters. How was the rhythm? Was it regular? Yeah. Yeah, exactly. So it was not a regular rhythm, not a mechanical rhythm, but what I would call, in classical terms, a rubato. So the rhythm was, it was quick, but it was changing within its temporal progression, and the tones were randomly selected. But normally, if you select it by random, you would get a lot of those things. But as you were listening closely, those notes are tied together. So this was one possibility, another one. So those notes are tied together. So there's a rhythm that has a certain tendency from one note to the other note not to go too far away. So it's a rhythm that's, in terms of physics, it could be described as a Brownian movement. So it's a rhythm that cannot go from this point to this point in the next instant, so it needs a space. Yeah, so it's a random with a certain behavior. It's not a stupid random like a dice or something like that.